Good afternoon, everybody. Unfortunately, one of my friends, relatives, passed away. He calls right now. He's sending the mother to Eretz Israel. He's asking, Rabbi, what's the best matzeva to put for my parents? Right now, in Eretz Israel, they offer him to put couple tombstone matzeva. He says, is it better to put tombstone for both of them? My father's still alive. My mother, he says his mother passed away. He sent her to Eretz Yisrael. So he's asking, what's the best tombstone to put? So I said, I'm going to look into this. And I found in Sefer Sha'ar HaMitzvot of the Arizal HaKadosh, if you remember a few days ago, we spoke about that how important it is to put the tombstone, the matzeva. How do you say matzeva in a tombstone in Russian? Magila?
Pamitnik?
Pamitnik. To put the pamitnik, the matzeva, we said on the seventh day. If a person is going to put it past the seventh day, the Arizal HaKadosh says that every when a person passes away, his neshama doesn't go just right away in a second. It takes 7 days for it to leave the world in stages. 7 makifim, the Arizal says. Every day, he says, there is 7 makifim goes to the body, whenever the body is in the ground, comes back with one less. Comes back with 6, goes another time, comes back with 5, goes another time, comes back with 4, and every day there is another makif remains by the body over there. Says the Arizal HaKadosh, I'm going to read to you over here. And the seventh day, as bevo makif aharon, kvar yesh bekoham lidchot haklipa misham, zulati chelek mimena. Velachar hatzaot ha'elu, katav od Arizal, lachen minhag bnei Ashkenaz, לא לבנות ציון על הקבר, עד אחר 7 ימי האבלות. לפי שטעם בניין הציון הוא, כאין כיסא ומושב לשרות עליו האורות המקיפים של הנפש. ועדיין לא נשלם המקיף לחנות שם, עד סוף 7 ימי האבלות. ואם יבנו תרם בכל המקיפים שם, אז אותה רוח חתומה נדבקת בנפש הפנימית של המת, שורה על הציון ההוא ומתגברת שם, ולא תזוז משם לעולם. Look what the words of the Arizal HaKadosh says. Scary words. He says that even the Ashkenazim that usually don't follow Kabbalah, so usually Ashkenazim follow whatever, Poskim, Rishonim say, Gemara say. Here it says even the Ashkenazim that they usually don't follow Kabbalah, even they have a minhag that do not put the tombstone, the pamidnik, before the seventh day. He says, why? Lefi shetam binyan ha-tziyun ahu, hu ke'en kiseh u-moshav lishrot alav ha-orot ha-makifim shel ha-nefesh. He says, this tombstone, this pamitnik that you put, this is a chair for the nefesh, or makifim of the nefesh. He says, if a person is going to put the pamitnik, the matzeva, earlier than seventh day, im ivnu terem ba'kol ha-makifim sham, az ota ruach hatuma nidbeket ba'nefesh ha-pnimit, v'shora al ha-tziyun ve'lo tazuz misham le'olam. He says, then if a person is put it earlier than the seventh day, a tum'ah, spirit, ruach, comes attached to that nefesh and will not remove from there ever. Imagine this. Lot azun misham le'olam. How serious it is. If a person put a pamitnik, a tombstone, before the seventh day. Now what happened when a person has a couple, husband and wife, tombstone? Do you know what happens? Whenever chas v'shalom, one of them passes away, the guy is coming from the cemetery to pick up that big stone. They let the body in. Where do you think they're going to put that tombstone? Huh? Back. Where are they going to put it? Right back. You think they're going to wait 7 days for you? Huh? They have to bring another time the people, another time the manov. Well, most people are not going to do that. So they have no room for that. It's a big rock like this for both of them, husband and wife. Where are they going to put it? So that's why, if you already have such a situation, make sure that you make a certain deal with the cemetery. Because if a person is going to put the tombstone, the matzeva, earlier than the seventh day, says the Arizal, there is a certain spirit comes to the nefesh of this person, then that spirit, it's a bad spirit, evil spirit, ruach tumah, that will link itself to that nefesh and will not leave it ever. You understand that? Nikagdai bon yastavit gavri. That's how serious it is for a person to make sure, Gemara says in Masechet Brachot, I remember now, in Daf Chet, Gemara says a person have to pray le'et metzo. The Gemara says, what is le'et metzo? Al zot itpalel kol hasid elecha le'et metzo. Says the Gemara in Daf Chet, what is the le'et metzo? Says the Gemara, "Et metzozo kevura," that if when a person passes away, he has to Hashem say, "When I'm going to pass away, make sure my kevura, my burial, everything's supposed to be done, will be done the right way." So this, Rabotai, I think a common mistake that people are just buying the tombstones whenever they are alive. I'm not talking only about the double one, the couple one. Even the one that is by individual. Person buys a lot in Eretz Israel or here, doesn't matter. And he says, "I already want to have everything ready." He puts his name, he puts his date of birth, just the ending birth, he leaves open check, as much as Hashem is going to give. Whenever he goes Ba'olam Haba, they put the date and they close it. He thinks, "I'm doing the best, I'm preparing myself, the tombstone for myself, Matzeva for myself." But we see it from the words of the Arizal, it's not good at all. So therefore, if a person is able to either cut a deal with the cemetery somehow and make sure that tombstone is not going to be placed before the seventh day, that's the best. So this way you have a ready tombstone, on the seventh day it's going to be placed. But if they are not willing to do so, I don't know what to do with this. Get rid of it, tell the cemetery, sell it, whatever, with money, everything you sold. Top, if you're able to pay them with money, make sure there are people like this, that they have relatives in Eretz Yisrael or here, make sure that tombstone that they bought, it's not going to be placed earlier than the seventh day. If you want to follow according to the Arizal HaKadosh and make sure that your parents are going to rest in peace without any evil spirit connected to them, it's going to be 100% resting in peace. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen. How big it is? We spoke about this already. Three tefachim by three tefachim by one tefach. Three kulaki. On the seventh day, this is the matzeva. That's the main matzeva. That could be the only matzeva. There are people that put the fancy one with the rest of the things. It's gav bekor. It doesn't need it anymore. The main one is this. The three tfachim by one tefach. That's the real matzeva. Everything else fancy that people put after, no point for it already. Just to make beautiful. But the bahalacha, that's the real matzeva.
It should be on top of that one. We don't want to move the...
Right. This was spoke about earlier. Yeah. That it's supposed to be. The real matzeva is the one that is going to be there. The one that you're going to put the fancy one, make sure you put on top of it. This one, put inside the ground, and the fancy one, you're going to put on top of that. But that's all only at the seventh day. It's supposed to be not earlier than the seventh day.
Later.
So, later, also no good. Seventh morning, on the head of the relative, it's supposed to be on top of the head. On the seventh morning, not earlier and not later. Like this, you're going to clean the neshama without any bad spirit to connect to this neshama. It's going to rest in peace 100%.